And if you just locked in, this is the R&B show of myself, Red at the Don. And I'm here with a very special guest. Reeseline's in the building.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm alive. How are you?
You're alive?
Yes.
Oh, God, that's not good. But when you say I'm not good or anything, like.
You're just skating across life.
Yeah, okay. You're surviving.
Uh-huh.
That's not good either. We want to be good. We want to be happy.
Yes.
Even if it's fake.
Okay, yeah. I'm great. I'm amazing.
You're amazing.
That's good.
I hear it. We're just talking about how you're a troublemaker. Yeah, on blast, 100%. Yeah.
Wait a minute. Mm-hmm.
Is that true?
Sometimes. And I mean sometimes.
Okay. Yeah. What star sign are you? Say it. Don't be scared.
No,
what are you? What star sign are you? I'll find out your government name today.
Aries. So, oh, no, wait.
You're an Aries.
I'm an Aries, yeah.
Okay, I understand why you didn't want to say it still. I hear it.
Wait, what's that supposed to mean?
Huh? You might love beef too much, man.
Do you know what? And I could handle it.
You could, yeah, but other people, for me, as a sensitive Virgo,
babe.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, I can't be asked to pull the pasta, do you know what I mean?
Okay. So. I don't go for people unless they come for me. That's it.
That remains to be seen.
Okay.
How's summer been so far?
It's been cool.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of heat that I hate.
You hate the heat?
I hate the heat.
Darling, please don't. What?
Give me
are you not Grenadian?
No. I'm
where
Jamaican,
you
I said Lucian.
Okay, so you're from the islands.
But this heat hurts. This heat hurts. I don't like this heat. It burns. And then the hay fever. I'm dying
See, I'm not one of those men. So I don't get beat up by pollen.
I hate people like you that do things.
What? Because I can breathe in summer.
I barely
And my eyes don't water in the summer. Because like at the 10 barbecues, you hate me. That's crazy.
I feel attacked. It's not my fault.
I mean, you're attacked by pollen. You might as well get attacked by something else as well.
I mean, I blame my grandparents. They should have stayed.
Back of yard, innit?
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
Get off that boat. Now,
for people that don't know who you are, do you want to give them a quick background on who Reeseline is?
Oh, I'm an R&B singer from South London all day.
Selfish.
Sorry?
Nothing. Continue.
I sing, songwrite, and I'm just starting out in the game. So.
My intro to you is you as a songwriter.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
How?
I don't know, but I always knew you as a songwriter before I knew you as an artist.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard about you.
Through the streets?
Yeah.
Okay.
But good things though, like your pen is dope.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, I've been
working on it.
No, your pen is really good. Like, I wanted to get you with my artist before things happened.
Yeah.
But, life, man.
Yeah, moving
life,
on.
You know, life, you know what I'm saying? So, how long have you been songwriting for?
Ooh, should I be cliche?
Yeah, do it. I've been writing my whole life.
Since I was 12.
Yeah,
It was me, but I was crap.
That's real?
I was crap. No,
that's real.
You look back.
Yeah.
But the potential was always there.
Right.
So then when I started really taking it, when I was like 17.
How did you get better?
Practice. Research.
Research how? Because I'm very intrigued by this.
I looked at my favorite songs and popular songs as well. I looked at the formula and I tried to match how I could make it my own. And then that's how I managed. Because I've got my own formula that seems to work for me.
Yeah.
But yeah, definitely research.
I heard that. And what made you want to get into like songwriting?
Oh, did you know what? It was an awkward situation, just laying vocals for like a producer. And
then
he was like, oh, can you actually write so I can pitch to other people? And then he was like, do you know, you're kind of dope still. And then that's how it came across. But before it was for fun, but then I started to realize there was a gift there.
Yeah. Was you good at English in school?
Yes. I sucked everything else.
Yeah. I mean, not for me. It was the other way around. I was terrible at English, but everything else I was... Yeah, I slept during my English literature
exam. I did that for science.
Yeah,
you couldn't find me.
Yeah,
goodbye.
Did not give a damn.
But stay in school, kids.
Yeah, stay in school. Stay in school, you know what I mean? Or get a trade.
Yeah.
Because we always need plumbers.
Period.
No, we always do though.
We do.
You know what I mean? Like, larger the tradesmen,
mm-hmm.
the essential workers. So what are songwriters do you mess with today? Like, who's your favorites?
Oh, Victoria Monet.
Of course.
From the get-go. I'm talking about before y'all were on my mama.
100%.
The Ariana Grande
I just found a new love. Yeah. Which is a Janet Jackson bag, you know what I mean?
You know?
Yeah.
Love that. So, Ariana.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I couldn't say that name. Sorry, they're cancelled. Okay.
Oh, I wonder who that is afterwards.
Oh, never mind. But like, there's so many people, especially that are becoming artists now today, that started off songwriting, and that's how I found out about them. So yeah, just a lot of background. But Victoria wins. Hello.
I hear you. Victoria, for me, I love Party. Chris Brown, I love.
Yeah.
There's a few still.
Seven.
Seven's the, like, she's dope, though. Like, she's just like, she's yeah, Seven. I really like Camille.
Oh, I love Camille.
Some UK, I love Bella's Pen.
Yes.
Tamera's my favorite. Yes.
I love her. Yeah, her she does her own little.
Yeah. Sam Tompkins, I really like his pen as well.
I've not really heard of him. Maybe I need to do my research.
Sam Tompkins
is hot.
He's the guy.
Okay.
Yeah, he's dope. He's very, very vulnerable. Mm-hmm. Like, it's, oh.
He's in his bag. Do you like vulnerable songs?
He makes me feel things. I do.
I didn't expect that.
What did you expect from me? I'm intrigued.
Hardcore.
Like what? Like whom? I like vulnerable. Make me feel.
So you're one of those guys that appreciate like R&B in the rain.
Yes.
Those vibes.
Maybe not, because some girls don't deserve that. But like,
yikes.
Make me feel.
And do you?
What, deserve a girl outside in the rain with a boombox? 100 million percent. I'm definitely worth that.
Girls have edges. We can't be outside.
Listen, after I come out and we will lay them together inside.
Oh, okay.
I'm a real romantic, bro. What do you mean?
For the cameras. And the radio.
You know what I'm saying? PR's everything, baby. You know what I'm saying? But how long after songwriting did you decide you wanted to become an artist?
It was deep down.
Deep down?
In my soul.
Was it a confidence thing? Was it like, oh, I don't know if I'm good enough?
So I come from a musical family.
Amazing.
And it was very much like, oh, it's so hard. Just do, because I did background vocals before. Mm-hmm. So it was, you know, stay in the back. Yeah, that's what I knew.
Right.
And then it's very unlikely for you to be a star. You know, unfortunately, they were keeping it real. Yeah. You know how did the Temptations get a $5 deal?
Yeah, they didn't
want that for me. So I was supposed to be a nurse and marriage counselor.
You're so Jamaican, Jesus Christ.
Really? My mom said, yes, you're going to school. I said, But yeah, and then I think I had encouragement by someone that meant a lot to me at the time.
Yeah.
Hello, not anymore. And then I took the risk and then I started to like.
So because of him, you've started singing, is what you're saying?
I feel like the confidence, but stop giving the man so much.
Why? I feel like we don't get enough credit.
Yuck.
So large up him, whoever he is, wherever he is, for helping you start your music career.
Trauma. Well.
Listen, but I'm about that though. I love you know, heartbreak as well, R&B.
Yeah, it gives you a story.
So, large up, see, that's why, you know, let's talk about your single before we start getting into some toxic stuff.
Yeah.
It's giving 2000s type, you know what I mean?
Period.
You know what I mean?
All
that's giving
vibes.
Like, yeah. Rhys Celine is still in the building. This is, I'm about to say something else there. This is Represent Radio. And it's the R&B show. I'm still with Rhys Celine. Now, Rhys, what is pressure about? Be honest.
Applying pressure.
To whom and to what?
To who you're pursuing. Like, people just pursue and then they don't show me what I get to gain from this.
Oh, so you don't pursue, you don't apply pressure, they apply pressure.
If you want them to apply pressure.
But what if you want them?
Yeah, then I'll do the same.
Okay, so you
move. But it's not about that.
You move to Mandem, yeah?
No.
This is the problem.
Let me tell you, I've got my strategies, and if I throw.
Oh, you got strategies.
Yeah,
okay.
But if I throw my little net and you don't collect it, game over.
Are you one of those girls that the one chance and that's it? Like, I gave you a chance and you didn't move to me, now it's collapsed forever.
Yeah.
Why?
Because I need that pressure. How do I know if you want me if you don't show me that you want me?
Maybe life is life-ing right now.
Okay.
Well, if I want you, but at the same time, I got bills.
Okay, so stay there with your bills, and when you're ready, then you can come back. I've got bills too. I'm taking care of myself. I don't need someone else's trauma, their pain.
This is why I'm not moving to you, because you know I have pressure from other places.
I mean, no, I just feel like there's a certain way to go about it, and women, I don't feel like we get that lovely treatment.
Really?
No. I feel like there's too many guys out here that don't want to take care of women, and then they wonder why us women are not submissive.
Women have fought for how much years to not be taken care of. They want to be independent, so let them do their thing.
That was them.
You see what the God? No, I can't get into it. Well, it's like this. Yes, so, this generation is so funny. At the same time, they say they want to be independent and I want my own bag. And then, but I also want to be taken care of and I want to be submissive. And which is it, Uchiwale? Is it One Mic? Which one is it?
Why can't I have both?
Because it doesn't work like that. It doesn't.
It does. I have my own things that I want to achieve. Okay. I want to make sure I'm looked after. And then anyone that I'm with, he needs to be able to match my energy and more. Because why am I going to be with a man?
I'll be so real. I'm not looking after you, bro.
What?
I'm looking after you for
what? My nails? No, my hair?
For what? You go work. You have a salary. Do it.
Why? Okay, tell me why you don't want to take care of your woman.
I know, I love to do that.
So what the heck are you
doing? I'm just fighting this case. Me, I love to spoil my babes. I love it.
I spoil men too, though.
I will spend most of my paycheck on the... Listen.
Oh, so you're a sucker.
No, I am a trick. I am a trick. It's different. I'm not a sucker. Don't call me that again. I'll collapse this whole interview.
You out here tricking? Oh, my God.
I mean, on women I love, you're 100%. I love spending money
on women.
Exactly.
I do reciprocate the energy there.
You spend money back?
Yeah.
Amazing. That's good. I like chains. You know what I'm saying?
I
hear you though. I love. Oh, it's just that. You know that moment when they. Oh my god. Yeah. That moment. That moment.
I love a little blush. Yeah.
That moment is the best. You're really good at TikTok. Why are you saying like that?
No, because it's so embarrassing.
Why is it embarrassing?
I'm so shy.
Shy about what? You're good at TikTok, no?
Yeah,
because
when people actually say it to me, I'm like, okay. Like,
but you're doing what you're meant to be doing.
Yeah.
What'd
I found my
there?
Formula.
What do you do in there?
I sing.
You sing? But how do you sing?
I be singing my ass off.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
With a little pink mic.
My mic is called Pinkles.
Oh, it's got a name.
It's got a name.
Pinkles, word.
Yeah, and we have like the mood background and I'm just singing my ass off in my house because no one wants to book me.
Oh my God. Okay. Right. I feel like we're in a different time now.
Yeah.
Like back like 6-7 years ago, I feel like I was in Shoreditch every week for a different event.
Okay.
For like up and coming artists and stuff.
Okay.
I don't think ever since the pandemic, there's not much of that anymore. Like price has gone up for everything, money gone up. It's just like it's harder to do. Yeah. And half of the venues are closed down.
Oh, is it?
Like birthdays is gone, like they closed down half of Dalston, like I think it's much harder to do. But you'll get bookings from what you're doing though. With TikTok and stuff.
I mean, I would love to have like a show and connect. Because I always see that under my videos. Like, when are we going to get a live show?
Yeah,
and I'm
100.
Just like, I don't know.
Do it.
No, yeah. But I also want it to relate back to my original music. Because I'm singing a lot of classical R&B songs that people love. But I don't feel like people actually know or they're just starting to know I'm an artist. Then they go on my page and they're like, oh, hey, you actually do. This.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hear you.
So yeah.
I feel you.
I'm a vocalist.
You're a vocalist. You're a vocalist, yeah. You went viral a couple times as well, innit?
Yeah.
What did you go viral for?
A singing. Folly. Taking the mick out of people singing.
Folly?
Yeah.
Who's Folly?
No, like doing dumb stuff.
Bad singing, imitating
celebrities.
Mm.
But I've gone viral like for 4 covers. That's 1+1 by Beyonce. Love by Keisha Cole.
Of course. Of course.
And there was 2 others. I think it was Burn from Usher.
Mm-hmm.
And I've done so many. It was a run from Tori Kelly from Sing.
Oh yeah.
And especially in Japan, they were eating me up.
Really?
Yeah.
So you got to Kyoto.
If I can get over there.
Yeah, it's expensive, so I can't lie. It's expensive.
Expensive paid, then I shall be there.
Say no more.
Hello.
What is your opinion on the TikTok strategy of like continuously posting? For like artists and music.
Boo.
Yeah.
Boo.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm begging.
It does feel like
it's
that,
begging.
Yeah.
And the algorithm can really shoot you in the foot.
I hate every algorithm.
Yeah.
Except Lucky Day's album. That's the only algorithm
I
like.
Oh my love.
Yeah.
You know how I feel.
Yeah, you love Lucky Day. Yeah. But I feel like it's a really, I hate that artists have to do that.
Yeah.
Like it really does feel, it's very close to slavery.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not close. It is
very
slavery.
Close. Yeah. It's horrible.
Yeah.
But fairs, man. Give me 3 R&B artists you're listening to right now. New.
New?
Mm.
New as in?
Up and coming. People don't really know about.
Tyler Lewis.
We love Tyler
I
Lewis.
I love her.
Oh, we love her. Represent.
She's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't say that they're new. But I'm really into Destin Conrad.
I love him so much.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He's everything to me.
He's the greatest.
Seeing him. Yeah. Like, and Ombre.
R&B is dope as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, R&B is really dope.
Which is the same kind of like...
They're both Kalani's kids.
Yeah. The babies.
Yeah.
So it's really, really dope. And
Kinead.
Oh, look. See, that's why I do. Like, yes, the vibe. Like, she's coming for the girlies next.
I'm saying like for Kinead, I said this earlier on before you was here. Like,
yeah.
For me, she's like the next, like, you see, we've got the Jazz, we've got Manili, we've got Bella. I feel like Kinead can really be the new...
She's got this central vibe.
Do you know what I mean? She's like, she's got everything. She can write, she can sing. Mm. Do you know what I mean? Like, she's a very nice person.
It's unusual, yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So, you're so annoying. You're so jarring.
It's normally one or the other.
No, she... Yeah. Bro, who are you taking shots at?
No one.
Are you sure?
It's the hay fever.
Oh, of course. You're getting beaten up by pollen again. That's crazy.
That's the only fight I ever lose.
See, that's the Aries, isn't it? So what's next for Risaline?
Ooh, guys, my EP is sitting there.
I mean, I've been waiting. I was told about your EP, a year ago?
I know. And it's just catching dust. But I haven't been in the studio since last year.
Okay.
So I'm actually working on part two.
Word.
But I'm just hoping that TikTok kind of keeps thriving for me. And I do want to drop a little bit more music before I do the EP.
Okay.
But the EP, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Hello. Okay. I think it's such a great debut. I can't wait for everyone to see it. So
amazing. You're going to drop it independently? You're going to shop it around? You're going
to... Yeah.
You don't have management right now, do you?
No. Oh, I've got a team.
Good.
Great team.
Good.
But I'm leading this boat here.
Okay.
Yeah. So.
Okay. You're controlling.
And it's working out great for me. Like the last 6 months. I'm not going to be a mean girl today.
Okay, good. I'm trying to sneak you in there. I'm trying to get your real personality out.
You asked. Media training.
That's amazing. Great. I'm going to trip you up there.